Duplicate content issues on Amazon KDP are a serious issue and in some circumstances can lead to getting your KDP account suspended or terminated. And this applies to whether you're creating and publishing KDP low content books or public domain works. So in this video, I'm going to show you a couple of solutions to reduce the risk of getting duplicate content warnings. And best of all, one of these solutions is absolutely free. Now, if you've not been to this channel before, then welcome. My name is Paul Marles and I do videos on how to make it, keep it and grow it. And that's your money I'm talking about. So imagine this scenario. You've gone online, you've found that perfect KDP PDF interior that you like. You upload it to Amazon, hit that publish button, only to get that sinking feeling when you receive a message saying that your book has been rejected, or you've received a duplicate content warning, or yet worse still, had your account suspended or terminated. And this applies mainly to those KDP low content books that have more original content inside them, such as coloring books, puzzle books, handwriting books, and those more complex and content rich low content books. So when people have asked me for solutions around this, I've normally recommended using software like Affinity Designer or Adobe Illustrator. The problem with those two methods are, one, the software isn't free, and two, it does require a bit of a steep learning curve to be able to use those pieces of software. So one of the solutions I'm going to show you is in Canva, which is free. It's web-based software as well, so there's nothing to download. And the other will be in Affinity Designer. So you can compare those two methods and see which ones you like the most. So first of all, we need our KDP PDF interior. And one of my go-to sites is Creative Fabrica. And I've just entered KDP interior into the search box and look at this, 48,000 results. There's a huge number of interiors on Creative Fabrica. So it's almost guaranteed you could find an interior for almost any type of book you want to publish. I'll leave a link to Creative Fabrica down in the description below if you're interested in checking that out. So just done a search and I've come across this alphabet letter tracing interior, which we're going to use. So I'm just going to click on download. Next, we go over to Canva. And the beauty of Canva is that it's also web-based, which means you can use it on virtually any platform. So the top right, click on create a design. Then bottom of this box, click on import file. And then we just need to open up the PDF version of the file that we've just downloaded. This will take a few moments to upload to Canva. And we can just click on that file to open it. And here we have our interior. So I'm just going to go to one of the pages here, increase the size to 75% so we can see it better. Now, if you click on areas of this page, you can see that a purple box appears around the elements that you click on, which means these elements are editable. So we can move them around, we can delete them completely, and we can change the wording and we can change the fonts on the page. So let's just change this font here of the words for ant, and let's choose this font, for instance. Now we'll just reduce the size of that so it fits better. Now we can see that each of these lines is also editable as we click on them. So we can move those around if we wanted to. And also these letters here are also editable. And again, we can move those around, delete them, whatever we wish. Now, what I'm going to do here is a quick example. I'll move this up so we can see it better and enlarge it a bit more. Is I'm going to remove these images down here at the bottom. I'm going to extend this line across. And this one. And this one. And I'm going to click on this letter A, copy, paste, and then move this into position. And there you can see we've got an extra line with our letter on. And if we want, holding down shift, we can click on these elements here, copy, paste, and just drag them down into position. Now, what I like about Canva, you can see here, it will tell us how far we've moved down, and we can set it to the same distance as the other lines. Reduce the size of this again. Now it's missing an image here. So over to Creative Fabrica again, and I've got this image of an ant, which I've downloaded. So all we need to do now is just drag that image onto our document, move it into position, reduce the size. And now obviously this is in color. we're going to be publishing a black and white interior. So we're just going to edit this image, and here we can change the colors in our image. Now we could move the saturation down, which would create a black and white image, or go to filters, scroll down and go to grayscale or street. I think grayscale will look okay. And there we have our page, which is now different to the original page and therefore is original. So you could go through each individual page, changing the elements as you wish, then saving that as a PDF file, which you can then upload to KDP. And hopefully this will then be treated as an original interior. Okay, now I told you I would show you the same in Affinity Designer, so you can compare the two. So all you do is get the PDF that you've downloaded to your computer, drag it into Affinity Designer, then open the document, and you can see here it will give you all the pages. And all you need to do is just enlarge this page and move it until you come to the page you want to edit. Now, the main difference between using Affinity Designer or Adobe Illustrator and Canva is that you may find that more of the elements of the page are editable. For instance, we can remove this individual image here, scroll that up, rather than having to remove the whole of the image. So you could take certain elements of the image, move them around, put that there, enlarge it, do all sorts of things. And again, you can just click on the text, edit the font to something different, move it around. And again, in the same way as we did previously, we can remove the image of the ant, put our ant image in, and again, we've got a more original page. And likewise, as with Canva, you just go through each page and edit them individually, save that as a PDF file, which is then ready to upload to the Amazon KDP platform. Now, I have tried various interiors on Canva with this. The majority were editable. You may find that some are not quite editable because it depends how the creator of the interior has created that particular interior. Sometimes they may have flattened the image or used PNG images to create the interiors, which may mean that not all the elements on the page are changeable. In which case, you would either have to use something like Affinity Designer, but it may be a problem even in that software, or just pick a different interior to edit. It's as simple as that. Now, I hope you found that useful. If you are new to this whole KDP publishing business, then I suggest watching my book tutorials playlist here, where I run through all the different aspects of creating and publishing no content and low content books on Amazon. Thank you very much for your time. It really is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And until next time, goodbye.